Having made a few small things on this lathe, there's a few things I want to improve. This tool rest is too annoying to adjust with a wrench. I need a better way of advancing this thing on the tailstock. This thing rattles a bit too much, and I need a better way to mount the motor. So the nut is tight in this orientation, so I'll just mark so that I can then put the lever on like so. So some of the rattling comes from these things being loose on here, so let's get rid of them. With the sleeves removed, this shaft can just go back and forth, and that's what this block on here is for, to lock it in place. Well, that's sounding a lot less rattly than it did before. I've been trying to think of a good way of adjusting this shaft forward, so I put a nail through here in a washer, and my idea was to put a spacer here, whatever size I need, and then a wedge, and I can just drive that deeper to move it forward and lock it in place. But if that wedge happens to be further up, it could slowly tip off and fall off, and then that could move back suddenly and release the workpiece, and that would be unsafe. My next thought was to put some kind of carriage bolt here, and then knob, and I could use that to push that forward, and there'd be some kind of block on here that would push the shaft forward. But of course it has friction in here, and this knob could undo itself from vibrations, and then eventually the shaft could move back suddenly. A better method is just to replace this whole shaft with a threaded rod. The reason I didn't want to do that is I was able to grind a perfect point onto this shaft, and I'm not sure if I can do that with a threaded rod, but I'll just give it a shot. So I'm going to use my lathe to spin up this shaft, and I made a sacrificial bearing block here because the threads are just going to chew it up. And then this needs to attach on here, and I've made an adapter that goes on here and fits on here. This might just work. I needed a tool rest for my angle grinder. That point came out just as good as my other one. I should have used that method in the first place. I made these blocks for a tight fit on the 12mm shaft, so my half-inch shaft is actually 12.7mm, which means that makes for an interference fit. But I just cut a keyway into here, and I'll use that to kind of grind a thread into the blocks. This little screw will act as a key to lock the wheel in place. With the workpiece spinning against this, this screw may gradually undo itself, so a wing nut or any sort of nut in here can lock that. Finally, I need to make a better way to mount that motor. Now I need to join these things to the back of the lathe, but I also need to be able to move it like this if I use different steps on the pulley. And I figure if I just join them in here into a board like that, and that gets screwed on here. The best way to join these pieces onto here, of course, is with a mortise and tenon joint, but I didn't want to use all my fancy tools, so I just kind of cut an open mortise with the table saw, and then these go in here. And then to close off the middle, I've got another piece, which I've made a little bit bigger, and I figure then I might as well glue another piece on here, and that'll make it really solid. Now, a lot of you are probably going to say, hey, you could just use the weight of the motor to tension the belt, but that's actually kind of a dumb idea, because these V-belts, they always shake a little bit, and if the motor's hanging off the V-belt, that means the motor too is shaking, and the motor's kind of heavy, and for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction, which means your whole lathe is going to shake, whereas this way, the belt is shaking, but it's very light, so it really can't shake the lathe very much. So that's it for this video. I still want to do a little bit more turning on here, and then I'll finally get around to making some kind of faceplate or chuck for doing bowl turning on here.